So five things which you can do when you are feeling or you are into I cannot read anymore zone. So whenever you are in such a zone, diagnose yourself well, okay? First, diagnose yourself that why am I feeling this? Have I read enough? Am I following my timetable correctly? And still I am into this zone where I'm not able to read or where I'm not able to focus. Then the reason could be you have exhausted yourself. You need to rest, okay? Do such activities which calms you, okay? It could be a meditation, it could be a good music, it could be a good talk with your mother, or it could be a company of your friend. But if your diagnosis is not this, then it could be that you are not consistent with your timetable, okay? You are stressing unnecessarily. And guys, mind you that this thing doesn't happen with you only, okay? It happens with everyone and it is completely normal, okay? So it is okay to diagnose yourself into this category where you are not following your schedule consistently, okay? You are reading it for 2 days and then you are wasting some time and then you are again reading. So this thing also happens. If this is happening with you, then the reason could be either the environment around you is not that much boosting or encouraging for you, okay? So stop listening to such people if you have around you, okay? If you are comparing yourself with your friends, with your peers, then please don't do it, because it is something which you are doing for yourself, okay? Remind yourself that why you started this preparation, why you chose this journey. And what do you want at the end of this journey? What is your end goal? Okay, remind yourself all these things and push yourself to get back on track. It is not easy. Guys, it is very easy to sit and cry, to sit and worry about things which are gonna happen in future, okay? This is what everyone does. But for me, you all are heroes, okay? Because you have chosen this course, you have guts to do something different. You have chosen this path which is tougher, okay? So you have to act like one. You have to push all your excuses aside and get yourself back on track. So now the diagnosis is done, okay? You will fall either of these categories. So now what you can do when you are very lazy, low on your energy and not enough motivated, okay? It happens. We wake up each day with limited amount of willpower, okay? And it gets exhausted as the day ends. So if you are feeling very low on energy, then what you can do? You can solve image-based questions. I suppose that everyone must be having dental pulse with them, okay? So dental pulse has 500 image-based questions. And when you will start solving it, it is kind of a different thing for your mind, okay? And as well, you can utilize this time by solving those image-based questions. Read its explanation, okay? Don't put any pressure on yourself. Just do it easily, okay? Just see the images, try to guess the correct answer and read the explanation. This way also you are saving your time and you are not feeling guilty that you are wasting your time. The second thing which you can do is revise the subjects which you have already read, okay? So I recommend each and every one of you to prepare a notebook of your own in which you are noting down the things which are difficult for you, or you know, there are some dates, there are some tables, some equations, some reactions, okay? So it is different for different subjects, but just write it down in your notes. So when you are feeling or when you are into this low energy zone, you can just flip through the pages and see the notes for an hour or for in 2 hours, okay? Just see it, just read it. No need to understand or mug up anything. It should just pass in front of your eyes, okay? That is it. Now the third thing which you can do is read your favorite subject. Guys, we have 20 subjects. Such a variety of platter NEET MTS has given to us, okay? So from 20, at least one could be your favorite subject, okay? So keep it closer to your heart, whichever is your favorite subject. It could be your dream branch in which you want to go, okay? So it's okay, take some time whenever you are feeling low or into a negative energy zone. Just pull that book of your favorite subject or your notes and just read it. Enjoy it. Okay? Don't think that you are reading it for marks, but just to understand it and just to take the feel of that subject, just read it. For me, it was dental anatomy and dental histology because it was smaller subject and I kind of love that subject. Now the fourth thing which you can do is you can watch YouTube videos. Yeah, there are lot many YouTube channels, okay, which are related to dentistry, which are related to medical, okay, and they are putting up amazing, fabulous content on it. So you can just browse whichever subject, whichever next mock test is there, okay, or whichever subject you might have finished, anything random, anything is difficult for you, then any subject, just it is easier to just sit and watch, okay, better than watching Netflix and Prime, right? Now the fifth but the most important thing, anatomy and pharmacology. These two subjects you have to revise it again and again, okay? So even if you are low on energy, push yourself towards these subjects, okay? Read at least one chapter or at least solve one chapter of anatomy or pharmacology even in these low energy times, okay? Because it is gonna be your biggest advantage at the end of the year. If you will push yourself today, it is gonna help you at the end for sure, okay? So don't forget to revise anatomy and pharmacology intermittently whenever you are low or whenever you don't want to start with another new subject. Just revise it again and again. Read the synopsis or the MCQs or the textbook, anything but anatomy and pharmacology, do it very clearly and the concepts should be crystal clear in your mind. So now I really hope that after seeing this video, none of you is gonna waste your time even when you are feeling low or when you are into that negative zone. Wishing you all a lot of positivity and strength.